Hey, everybody. We're going to do a fountain pen video. And it's going to be a Lamy fountain pen. And I own two Lamys. The first being this Lamy Safari. I've really enjoyed this pen. Man, some of you remember my Lamy All-Star, which is kind of like a Safari. If you're new to fountain pens, Lamy is a producer of writing instruments in Europe. And the company is German-owned. Josef Lamy founded the company in 1930. He had been a sales representative for the Parker Pen Company in Germany prior to that. Lamy was a pioneer in the use of molded synthetic plastics to make their products. And the Lamy Safari is such a an example of a plastic pen. And the Safari is a very contemporary, very hip pen. And I believe it was introduced in 1980. And it was designed by a man named Wolfgang Fabian, who was born in the 40s, 42 or perhaps 1943. And Wolfgang Fabian was a goldsmith before he studied industrial design. Now, like I said, 1980 was when the Safari was introduced. And sometime later, Lamy introduced the All-Star. And it was also designed by Mr. Fabian. And it's essentially the same pen as the Safari, except that the cap and the barrel, are made of aluminum, which is probably what the capital AL in the name stands for, All-Star. Now, being made of aluminum, The All-Star cap and barrel, I believe, are slightly larger in diameter than the Safari's plastic one. So the plastic cap on the Safari is about 500 and... Let's see, right, measured right here. 568 thousandths of an inch. But on the aluminum All-Star, it's 593 thousandths of an inch. So it's slightly bigger. And the widest point on the barrel of the Safari is about 493 thousandths of an inch. Whereas on the All-Star, it's about 504 thousandths. The color of this Safari is apple green. I don't remember if that was a special color, a limited color. I just don't recall. The color on this All-Star is ocean blue. And to the best of my knowledge, this is a limited edition color. Many people collect the Lamys. And Lamy is constantly coming out with special colors. Another difference between the All-Star and the Safari is the grip section. On the Safari, the grip section matches the barrel. They're the same color. But on the All-Star, the grip section is a translucent, smoky color, kind of a gray. Both pens incorporate the famous Lamy Z50 nib, which I understand the Z50 nib is available in extra fine, which is what this one is on the Safari. So you have extra fine, fine, medium, broad, and then you have some italics, such as the 1.1 millimeter italic, 1.5 millimeter italic, and 1.9 millimeter italic. And I think this is a 1.5. I can't really tell without putting a magnifying glass up to it. And I don't have a magnifying glass handy. And I think Lamy offers a left-handed Z50 nib as well. And I think it comes in medium. Now, as smooth writing as the Z50 nib is, I've often wondered if it would be even smoother if it were made of gold. But the standard Z50 nib is made of iron, nickel, and chromium. And some of you may realize that iron, nickel, and chromium is the ingredients for stainless steel. But I do believe that Lamy does offer a 14-karat gold Z50 nib. Seems like I remember reading that somewhere. Now, having said all of this about the Lamy Safari and All-Star, in this envelope is another All-Star. There's one for me. And there's one for a lucky patron. And we'll talk more about that in a little bit. And I'll tell you how you can possibly be the owner of this pen. But for now, I'll set this aside. So let's open this one up. This is a Lamy All-Star fountain pen, and the color is one of the special colors that Lamy made. It's a limited edition, and they call this one blue-green. And as you can see, this is one beautiful color. I thought the ocean blue was very nice, and still do. But this blue-green is just knocking my socks off. It's beautiful. And it has the big clip on it. By the way, the designer, Wolfgang Fabian, designed this clip so that it could be easily clipped into like the front pocket of your blue jeans. Because the Safari and the All-Star were marketed toward a younger generation of people. So what do you say we ink this pen up and give it a test? In between the grip section and the barrel, it ships with a small cardboard ring. And that is to keep you from screwing the barrel so far onto the grip section that the provided Lamy cartridge gets punctured. So if you want to use the provided cartridge, you would take this ring off. And put the cartridge in and push it until it snaps into place. At that point, the end of the cartridge will get punctured and the ink will flow to the nib. So obviously, Lamy doesn't want that to happen during shipping or anything. So hence the little cardboard ring. Now, I'm sure this is fine ink, but that's not the ink I'm going to use. I'm going to use some Noodler's Black. But to use the bottled ink, I'm going to need a ink converter. So when I purchased this pen, I spent $5 extra and got the ink converter. Let's see if I can get it out of the box without making too harsh of a noise. In there pretty good. Okay, here is the optional Z24 converter. This is what you need with a All-Star or a Safari if you want to use bottled ink. And as you can see, there's some little ears, little bosses on the outer diameter of this converter. Those will snap into the corresponding snap areas of the grip section that you see right here. Just line them up, push, and it should snap into place. Well, it's in place, but I did not hear it snap. But I could feel it go into place. Now, if you're new to fountain pens, to put ink into this converter, you need to just, there's a little plunger in here, a little black plunger. When the plunger goes up, it creates a vacuum and draws the ink into the pen. And we'll be dipping this end of the pen into the bottle of ink up to about here and drawing the ink in. I'll start at the top so that I can push air out of the system, and then I'll come back up and draw as much ink as possible, but there will still be a pretty good pocket of air, and I can get rid of most of that by going down one more time And then coming back up. Now, some of you wonder what I'm doing right now. I have this little habit of creating this sound. Some people find this relaxing, including myself. And you don't have to shake the ink, but I like the sound of it. Black. Now, before you ink a fountain pen, it's best to have something to blot the excess ink from the pen once you remove it from the bottle of ink. I just use a simple paper napkin. So let's see if I can do this without getting ink on my desk, without hitting my microphone. Okay, it's in. Let's draw some ink up. Let's get the air out, and then we'll come back up. As you can see, here's the air pocket that I was talking about. So I'm going to go back down with it and then come back up. And I should get a little bit more ink this time. Yeah, that's better. And you can see the ink that comes off of the pen and the nib. And let's screw the barrel on. Do this one more time. And let's put the cap on it. And let's move the ink out of the way. Here's a piece of paper from the box. And it's a warranty policy. And That's a nice looking pen. I'll take the label, the sticker off of it in a little bit. But right now, let's test the pen. This is a Moleskine. Notepad. Just a little bit of ink on my finger. And right now it appears to be a little overexposed for the paper, so let's adjust the exposure here. That's a little bit better. At least we can see the lines. Now the nib on this is a fine. And I'm going to post it. I usually write the cap. Posted. And as is always the problem when I make a video is with the camera in front of me, and by the way, I'm using an iPad mini to video this, I can't really get into the right position to write at my best. And as usual, this thing writes like butter. It has just the right amount of feedback to keep the pen from getting away from you. Some of you may know what I'm talking about with, say, like a rollerball type pen. They're so smooth that it's hard to control the pen. But with a fountain pen, there's enough resistance to keep it from just going crazy on you. Writes really nice. My Lamy Safari has a extra fine nib. But after writing with this fine, I think I like that better. In the future, I'll do a like a sleep aid writing video about just the sounds from this pen as I lay down some ink. Now, as expected, this nib doesn't really have any flex to it to speak of. And it's not meant to. It's just a smooth writing stainless steel nib. And I really do like it. Now, as I mentioned earlier, when I purchased this pen for myself, I purchased another one exactly like it, and it's in this box. And some of you may know that I have a Patreon page. And you can find the link to that in the description of this video. But I have some supporters of my channel that want to support this channel, and they want to see it grow, and so they throw a dollar or two my way. And ever since I've had my Patreon channel, I've wanted to somehow give back to the people that help support me through Patreon. So, in my next video, I'll talk a little bit about my Patreon page and what I'm going to try to start doing to pay back and the people that help me. So, I appreciate you watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it to be relaxing. And possibly you got a few ASMR tingles with it. Tell you what, I'm going to put these back in a case. Let's move this out of the way. These out of the way. Pull the case into view. And put the safari back in. And the ocean blue all-star. And something has to go for now. I'll find a new home for this pen. And I'll move this pen over. And we'll put the ocean blue. I'm sorry, the blue-green all-star right here. Thanks, everybody. I appreciate you watching.